Hi everyone, in continuation of our series of microbiology in which we are discussing urinary tract infections as per competency-based medical education, in video 5 in which we were discussing the non-gonococcal urethritis, this is our part 2. Here we will be discussing mycoplasmine and herpes simplex virus. Mycoplasma pneumoniae is also called as Eaton antigen, or it is also called as PPLO, that means pleuropneumonia-like organism. So Eaton antigen and then pleuropneumonia-like organism. Now pleuropneumonia-like organism, why you call it as pleuropneumonia? Why you give it a word pleuro? Because it has no fixed shape. Right, why it does not have a fixed shape? Because it is devoid of the cell wall. Now because it is devoid of a cell wall, and if you remember, the flagella is an extension of the cell wall, hence there is no flagella. So they are going to show motility with the help of fimbriae, and the type of motility stands to be gliding motility. And one more very important thing, that the cell membrane is having cholesterol. So what I have told you is in the introduction that it is called Eaton antigen, pleuropneumonia like antigen. Why pleuro? Because it does not have cell wall. So people say, okay, if it does not have cell wall, does it have flagella? No, it does not have flagella. It has got numerous fimbriae, and that is why it is showing gliding movement. Does it have cell membrane? Yes, and the cell membrane is having cholesterol inside it. This is about introduction. Next is lab diagnosis. Now, in lab diagnosis, what you are going to do, actually you are going to culture mycoplasma, and after culturing the mycoplasma, you are going to do the staining. After culture, you are going to do what? You are going to do staining. Now, this method is called as Dyne's method of staining. Dyne's method of staining. There is a very important MCQ which is going to ask you Dyne phenomena. Dyne phenomenon is by the Proteus. Okay, so phenomena is for Proteus, method is for mycoplasma. Okay, right. So staining मैंने आपको बता दिया, ठीक है. Specimen हमने कौन सा लेना है, we will discuss in a while. ठीक है, so first thing is actually specimen. वो कौन सा लेना है वी विल डिस्कस. देन स्टेनिंग आई टोल्ड यू दैट यू आर गोइंग टू यूज अ Dyne's मेथड ऑफ स्टेनिंग विच इज द कल्चर विच यू आर गोइंग टू यूज. द कल्चर इज योर Eaton agar एंड PPLO agar इन विच यू आर गोइंग टू हैव अ बुल आई कॉलोनी और अ फ्राइड एग कॉलोनीज. हाउ दिस फ्राइड एग्स लुक लाइक, देखा होगा ना हाफ फ्राई वाला अंडा कैसा दिखता है, वैसा ही बस खाली. ठीक है, मतलब लाइक दिस, बीच में यॉक पार्ट दिखेगा एंड साइड के अंदर वो जो वाइट 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 ऐसे रहता है. तो इस तरीके की कॉलोनीज दिखती हैं. सो PPLO agar और Eaton agar पे आपको बुल्स आई और फ्राइड एग कॉलोनीज जो हैं दिखेंगी. सो दिस वॉज अबाउट द कल्चर. सो एनीथिंग एल्स, या ऑब्वियसली योर देर आर टू टेस्ट विच यू शुड रिमेंबर द नेम्स ओनली, कोल्ड एग्लूटिनिन टेस्ट एंड स्ट्रेप्टोकोकल MG टेस्ट. Okay, cold agglutinin test and streptococcus MG test. Then fifth number pe serological. Okay, serological. Then tests mein rather you remember one more. One is your cold agglutinin, then your streptococcal MG test and DAFA. Now what is DAFA? DAFA is direct fluorescent antibody method. And in the end, wahi RT-PCR, ELISA. This is important. Okay. So what are the clinical features? Remember that this is a mycoplasma which is responsible for causing atypical pneumonia. Most common organism responsible for causing atypical pneumonia is mycoplasma. Okay. It is also responsible for causing fixed Fitz-Hugh-Curtis syndrome, that is a perihepatitis, more of which we will be discussing when we will be discussing gonorrhea. Then a non-gonococcal urethritis, again. This is important. And then erythema multiforme. So atypical pneumonia, then Fitz-Hugh-Curtis syndrome, then erythema multiforme, and then non-gonococcal urethritis. If you remember the vowels, A, E, I, O. Okay. So atypical pneumonia, erythema multiforme, then Fitzhugh-Curtis syndrome, non-gonococcal urethritis. If I summarize whole mycoplasma, introduction, Eaton antigen, PPLO, lac cell wall, lac flagella, have cholesterol, gliding movement. Okay. Then after introduction, you have selective media, Eaton agar, PPLO. Okay. Sorry. After introduction, you were having your lab diagnosis. So specimen collection, obviously, if it is an atypical pneumonia, you are going to collect a respiratory, like sputum or oropharyngeal. If it is a non-gonococcal urethritis, you are going to take a urine sample like that. Dines phenomena, you can do. Then staining ke baad mein, there is culture, PPLO, Eaton, bullseye, and then fried egg. Then tests, cold agglutinin, streptococcal MG. And one more test, which is very famous for this, is your, as I was telling you, that you can use DFA, that is direct fluorescent antibody detection test. After staining, serological RT-PCR ELISA, right? This was the mycoplasma. Next is your hepatitis, this is your herpes infection. See, in herpes, what is herpes now? Herpes is double-stranded, it is enveloped, and it is a icosahedral virus. Double-stranded, enveloped, and icosahedral virus. Okay. So herpes simplex virus or HSV is of two types, HHV1, HHV2. Matlab herpes simplex virus is HHV1, HHV2. That is human herpes virus 1, human herpes virus 2. What is the difference between the two? Remember, the human herpes virus 2 is going to infect below the waist mostly. It is more neurovirulent and it is more resistant to antivirals. Kul milakar ke zyada khatarnak hai. So the things which are shared by them is, it is double-stranded, icosahedral, enveloped. Herpes 2, human herpes 2 below the waist, herpes 1 above the waist, more resistant to antiviral is 2, less resistant is 1, and neurovirulent more is 1. Okay. So what are the clinical features, and then the lab diagnosis we will see. What are the clinical features you are going to see? Clinical features, remember, one is it is causing blisters. Okay. Actually, jo bhi skin hai ya mucous membrane pe, yahan par ye blisters cause karta hai. And these blisters, they are bursting to form the painful ulcers. Okay. Isko bolte ho herpetic ulcer or the cold sore. Why it is called cold sore? Because there is no inflammation. Aur agar jahan par inflammation nahi hoti, you know that calor is absent. That is why it is a cold sore. Okay. So blister will be there. After blister will be will burst to form the painful ulcers, and once it is bursting to form the painful ulcer, it is a cold sore. Why it is cold sore? Because there is no inflammation present. As the name suggests, herpes, this is herpetic vitello. Now, what is herpetic vitello? The dentist who are not using proper gloves, to unke hand se jo hai, it can transmit. So this is herpetic vitello. Okay. Erythema multiforme. Yes. Herpetic se hi dusra yaad rakhenge, herpetic keratitis. Okay. And one more very important thing, meningitis and encephalitis. Bahut hi important hai. Okay. Remember, meningitis mein temporal lobe affect karta hai, and this meningitis is called Mollaret's meningitis. Mollaret's meningitis. Remember, it is a congenital infection, and we will also discuss an important BAQ. This is, what are the congenital infections? Okay, we will discuss in a while. But what are the clinical features which it is showing? You must remember, for example, a person visits a dentist. ठीक है, उसको painful ulcer थे patient को, तो वो गया dentist के पास. ऐसे मैं कहानी बना रहा हूँ. Okay. So painful ulcer थे means what? Blisters होते हैं, painful ulcers, cold sores. वो गया dentist के पास, तो क्या हो जाएगा? Herpetic vitello. And once you know the herpetic vitello, you are supposed to remember herpetic keratitis. Okay? अब patient गया तो था अपनी बीमारी ठीक करने, but उसको vitello भी हो गया, keratitis भी हो गया, patient का दिमाग खराब. दिमाग खराब means meningitis, Mollaret's meningitis and encephalitis. And one more, this you have to remember, erythema multiforme. Now this is a congenital infection, means, yeah, what are the other congenital infections? You should remember torch infection, toxoplasma from TO, R for rubella, C cytomegalo, H hepatitis, HIV herpes, and S for syphilis. So toxoplasma, rubella, cytomegalo, herpes, hepatitis, HIV, and syphilis. Okay, so these are the infections. Lab diagnosis के अंदर में या obviously firstly specimen collection जो है वो आप लोग देख सकते हैं, depends कि उसका क्या manifestation है. Second one is staining, there is no stain which they are going to pick, ठीक है, no stain, but yeah, you are using a Zanc smear. अगर बहुत सारे Zanc smear जब आप लेते हो तो you are going to see multiple giant cells will be there, ठीक है ना. For example, if I make a blood smear, and in the blood smear I'm going to see lot of giant cells, okay, so that is Zanc smear. तो वो आप staining के अंदर लिख सकते हो. Being a virus, there is no specific culture media which is there, okay, so culture media होता नहीं. RT-PCR ELISA आप कर सकते हैं, this is all, okay. So structure कैसा होता है, that we have discussed initially. Then difference between HHV-1, HHV-2, then clinical features and lab diagnosis. This comes to the end. Thank you for joining.